Hi, everyone. I'm Eric Bolling. Welcome to Cashin In. Our Cashin In crew this week, Jonathan Honig, Michelle Fields, Juan Williams, and Ashley Pratte from the great group, the Young Americas Foundation. Thank you. Welcome, everybody. President Obama is saying our American workforce should be more like France.
If France can figure this out, we can figure it out.
The president pushing new French-like work rules, including more flexible schedules and extra paid family leave time, but with a double-digit unemployment rate and a top tax rate of 75%. Jonathan, why would President Obama want America to be more socialist than capitalist?
Well, his philosophy isn't that of an American era, Eric. I mean, his philosophy is against a free market and a free society. So when the president talks about workplace benefits, he's talking about government force over the economy, and you've certainly had that in France. You know, in France, the maximum work week is 35 hours. Employees get paid vacation after a month. They get their travel to and from work paid for. They get their lunches paid for. You know what the net result has been? Unemployment above 8% since the 1980s. If that's what the president's advocating for, he can keep it.
Again, his unemployment rate at 10.4% now. Michelle, let's
currently
talk about this a little bit. Young people in France, 23% unemployment rate versus about a 13%, still elevated here, yet why would we mimic more of what's going on poorly elsewhere?
Well, look, I think a basic economic rule of thumb is that if France is doing it, we should not be doing it. And I think it's kind of funny that this president is giving business advice when this president has never even run a lemonade stand. We should not want to be like France. We should want to be the opposite of France. When French workers were forced to have to work more than 35 hours a week, they went out on the streets to burn tires. Is that really the type of society that we want, an entitled society where they go out and protest because they have to work?
Well, Juan, let me ask you this. Are the crepes and croissants so good in France that President Obama says, let's be more like them?
You know, this is so ridiculous. First of all, the president was speaking in jest. The whole idea was, we're a stronger economy than France. We have better economic measures on
every scale.
So
why do we want to be
like
them? That's why our GDP is shrinking?
And therefore, we can do better in terms of reducing stress on American working families by offering them flexible hours, equal pay for equal work, making sure that children have some child care provisions that don't bankrupt
American
families.
Oh, I see. He was just kidding. He was just kidding about we should be more like France.
He wasn't kidding.
Was he kidding about you can keep your doctor, or was he kidding about you didn't build that? I'm not sure when he's kidding.
No, I think you're kidding because you just want to claim he's a socialist. But it's not socialism. It's common sense.
But he's mimicking
our policies. Jump in here and add some sanity to this discussion, Ashley.
Yeah, I believe that France and this, you know, this is fact, they're trapped by a welfare state that's killing jobs and killing economic opportunity. There was actually a video put out by CBN News in Paris where they had a poll that was conducted that half of the young people that were in France currently would leave. And that's because there's zero economic opportunity with a 23% unemployment rate. And here in the United States for 18 to 34-year-olds, that's 18.1%. So we're actually, you know, getting to the point where we're becoming France.
John, you take this. But Ashley's right. We're more than halfway there. We're with our tax rates exploding under President Obama. We're making less. Costs are going up. It really is starting to feel like a French economy here.
And with Obamacare and our expanding welfare state,
Go ahead, John.
Yeah, well, Eric, what's always made us successful, and Juan talks about how strong the economy is. I don't know if I agree with that, but what's always made us a strong economy is the fact that we're not like France. American exceptionalism means that unlike every other country, including France in the world, your life belongs to you. Your business belongs to you, and it's not government's role to come in and tell you how to run your business. It's that individualism which has made us successful, and the president is obviously against, because when he talks about offering this and offering that, he's talking about bringing a gun into your workforce and making you act in a way you wouldn't
Jonathan, I'm saying to you that we as Americans have Social Security. We have Medicare, Medicaid to help our elderly. Is that
Juanito, one moment, please. Let's throw a couple of full screens up there. Take a look at median household income, French versus ours. Look at that. We're almost double their median household income. I don't know if we have a full screen or not for this one, but the gross domestic product per person in France is about $35,000 a year. In America, it's $53,000 a year. Juan, President Obama wants us to be more like France. He's going to bankrupt us, all of us.
No, we're a stronger economy. He's saying we can do better than the French.
Why?
We should be able to do better.
We have an expanding welfare state on, and with Obamacare, our economy is unsustainable.
Guys, one at a time. Michelle first, then Ashley.
Look,
go, Michelle.
All of these ideas are very great ideas. They're wonderful. They're idealistic. But the point is, who is going to pay for this? The economy is going to pay for this. It's going to result in less jobs. Is that really what we want, Juan? Yes, this is great, but we can't do it. Who's going to pay for it?
We have to admit, Ashley, that in America, the social network that Juan points out is extensive. It's vast. 46 million people on food stamps. Literally, trillions of dollars under President Obama is being transferred from those who have to those who need. But it doesn't. But we should do more. Juan's saying, and President Obama, I think, is saying, we just don't do it.
Well, then, Eric, I would like to point something out then, in that in France, we're seeing the wealthiest people leaving because the taxes are so high. So these people that Obama is expecting to subsidize these great and ideal programs are now going to leave America if we become France, because taxes will be too high. So he'll have no one to pay for these idealistic things, or the 46 million people that are on food stamps and becoming a dependent class here in America.
Right. And Juan, hold on. Ashley pointed something out. You know, for a while, France was playing around with a 75% top income tax rate. Yeah. And I think they pushed back on that. They actually tried to get it into law. They're pushing back, but nonetheless, their taxes are higher than ours. Their social network is higher than ours. They give away a lot of stuff. People aren't working in France the way they work in America. We want to be more like that?
No, we don't. We want to do better. That's the whole point of what the president said.
So we want
but
to become France. That's going to be the result.
I find Ashley and Michelle to be the people who should say, you know, if I have a kid, I want to make sure my family can stay together. I don't have to choose between my job and my family.
I want to be subsidized by the federal government.
Oh, go ahead, John.
Yeah, Juan's only answer is federal government. What makes us better is making us freer, not more dependent on others.
Making us stronger, Jonathan.
Not more dependent on government.
Families.
I value a free society. I don't want people to take care of me.
I've completely lost control of this block. But while we did this, we ran out of time. It's obviously a hot topic.